Welcome the graduating pupils of class 2020-2021 with their parents and class advisors. Grade 6 Excel. Grade 6 Faith. Grade 6 Hope. Thank you. Grade 6 Joy.
Thank you.
staff of CPU Elementary School, headed by Professor Janet P. Hako.
Rejoice with you, our beloved CPU elementary pupils, for a very important achievement in your academic journey, your elementary graduation. Prior to your graduation ceremonies, it has been a tradition of CPU to hold this Dedication Sunday, where we could express our gratitude to God in worship for all the wonderful things He has done in your lives. And of course, to dedicate your lives to the Lord. We believe that we can never achieve things of eternal value without the blessings of the Almighty. We would have been gathered at the University Church if not for this pandemic, but for the sake of public safety, however, we decided to do it virtually. May the mode of our celebration will not diminish the meaning of our worship experience. We would like to commend your parents, guardians, and teachers whose love and support for you help you to finish strong. Most of all, highest praise to the Lord Almighty, in whom we live, move, and have our being. On behalf of the pastors of the University Church, we warmly welcome all of you to our dedication service. May we have a joyful celebration. Thank you.
Shout for joy to the Lord, all the earth. Worship the Lord with gladness. Come before Him with joyful songs. Know that the Lord is God. It is He who made us, and we are His. We are His people and the sheep of His pasture. Enter His gates with thanksgiving and His courts with praise. Give thanks to Him and praise His name. For the Lord is good, and His love endures forever. His faithfulness continues through all generations.
Let's bring a praise and glory to our God, the God of glory, the Lord of love. Joyful, joyful, we adore Thee, God of glory, Lord of love. Hearts unfold like flowers before Thee, opening to the sun above. Melt the clouds of sin and sadness, drive the dark of doubt away. All Thy works rejoice around Thee, earth and heaven reflect Thy rays, stars and angels sing around Thee, center of unbroken praise. Field and forest, vale and mountain, flowery meadow, flashing sea, chanting bird and flowing fountain, call us to rejoice in Thee. Thou art giving and forgiving, ever blessing, ever blessed, wellspring of the joy of living, ocean rest. Thou our Father, Christ our brother, all who live in love are Thine. Teach us how to love each other, lift us to the joy divine. Mortals, join the which the morning stars began. Father, love is reigning o'er us. Brother, love binds man to man. Ever singing, march we onward, victors in the midst of strife. Joyful music leads us onward in the triumph song of life. And oh, bless the Lord, oh my soul, bless His holy name. All praise to God who reigns above in majesty supreme, who gave His Son for all to die, that He might man redeem. Blessed be the name, blessed be the name, blessed be the name of the Lord. Blessed be the name, blessed be the name, blessed be the name of the Lord. His name above all names shall stand, exalted more and more. He's seated at God's own right hand, where angel hosts adore. Blessed be the name, blessed be the name, blessed be the name of the Lord. Blessed be the name, oh blessed be the name, blessed be the name of the Lord. Redeemer, Savior, friend of all, once ruined by the salvation's call, for thou hast died for all. Oh, blessed be the name, blessed be the name, blessed be the name of the Lord. Blessed be the name, blessed be the name, blessed be the name of the Lord. His name shall be the Counselor, the Mighty Prince of Peace. Of all earth's kingdoms conqueror, whose reign shall never cease. Blessed be the name, oh blessed be the name, blessed be the name of the Lord. Blessed be the name, blessed be the name, blessed be the name of the Lord.
Let us pray. Our most gracious and heavenly Father, you are great and powerful Lord, for everything on earth and in heaven is yours. You are exalted as head over all. You are the ruler of all things. In your hands are strength and power to exalt and give strength to all. All around us we see reflections of your love, mercy, grace, and beauty. You are an unchanging God. You are the same today as yesterday, and your faithfulness never ceases. You alone deserve our praise and thanksgiving. We give back all the glory and honor to your glorious holy name. We pray. Amen.
My family's journey in CPU Elementary School started 9 years ago when we were looking for a school for our eldest child. He had just taken an entrance exam in one of the big public schools that afternoon when his father and I, along with his two younger siblings who were toddlers then, decided to visit certain schools in the neighboring areas. I can still vividly remember my son's wide, big eyes and jaw-dropping wow when we were making a turn at the flagpole. We parked the car and I, who was about to answer the call of nature, instinctively held my son's hand and hurriedly went to the comfort room near the dining hall. While inside the cubicle, my son was outside and telling me, "Nanay, I want to study here because even the toilet is so clean." I was smiling because earlier that day, he would not enter the toilet of one of the schools because it's dark and full of cobwebs. I was not prepared for that firm, decisive, and outright declaration from a six-year-old. I just told him, "Okay, your tata and I will talk about it, and you have to pass the entrance exam first." We gathered information about the institution that will nurture the formative years of our children and made the ultimate choice to enroll. I wanted to share two of the things that we considered in making that decision. For one, the excellent Christian education is a shared value because we too wanted to raise critical, God-fearing, and compassionate next-in-line human beings. Secondly, its school system had been perfected for more than a century and had molded thousands of great minds. Admittedly though, funny as it sounds, the toilet impression was one of the biggest factors that was also considered because we believe that cleanliness is next to godliness. And truly the choice we made of putting our children in CPU Elementary School was by far the best conjugal decision we ever made. The institution provided opportunities for our children to develop independence and sense of responsibility. The lunch card in the dining hall and the locker system taught my son to be on his own at the age of 8 and 9. The school calendar and regular summative tests developed the study habits of my children and taught our family the beauty of planning, regularity, and order. The class daily devotions and Christ Emphasis Week taught them to put God first and that in everything, whether they eat or drink, they should glorify Him. The vast resources of books in the library widened the imagination of my passionate reader daughter. Amazingly, it has an updated list of favorite authors of today's generation. The strict and decisive teachers taught them the value of submission and eliminated their sense of entitlement. I remember one of my children going home telling me that one of his teachers is not afraid of anything, even of her mom or her dad. I told him, of course, because parents were also once under the rule. There were also gentle teachers who inspired them to do more because they can do better and be the best version of themselves in the future. My involvement in the PTA as officer brought joy and sense of affirmation to my children because in their eyes, love is also spelled T-I-M-E. Our family is far from perfect. There was a time when we were always late every morning, unfinished project, late submission of assignments, and I know that this has also affected their self-esteem. But this has also taught them to face their flaws and imperfections, to stand up and face the consequences of their actions. Thus, doing their part and cooperating became the theme of our early morning routines. Lastly, I am grateful to God for the sense of accountability and community among parents and teachers, and the shared value that each child matters. This is also an affirmation that indeed it takes a village to raise a child. Who can forget their care and thoughtfulness during times when my children needed an adult beside them? These guardians and parents did not hesitate to offer food during lunch and even did the hair and makeup during special activities. Truly, CPU Elementary School acknowledges that our children are a heritage and gift from the Lord. Psalm 127, verse 3. To our beloved teachers, led by Professor Jeanette Paguntalan-Hako, thank you very much for optimizing the potentials of our children. You made our mission as parents and stewards of these children bearable and meaningful. To God be the glory for what He has done, is doing, and will do with each child in this institution. Thank you very much.
I will be reading from the book of Isaiah, chapter 41, verse 10. So do not fear, for I am with you. Do not be dismayed, for I am your God. I will strengthen you and help you. I will uphold you with my righteous right hand. Another verse came from Jeremiah, chapter 29, verse 11. For I know the plans I have for you, declares the Lord, plans to prosper you and not to harm you, plans to give you hope and a future. May God add blessings to the reading of His Word.
just drifts away. And as I look back on the years, memories of happiness and bitter tears. Through it all there was a common thread that cannot be ignored. You were there teaching me to be your servant.
Our speaker for today is a full-blooded Centralian. In fact, he loves CPU so much that he spent not just 4, 5, but 11 years at Central, and he wasn't even studying medicine. He says that if God hadn't called him to be a pastor, he might still be enjoying his studies until now. Finally, and thankfully, in 2011, he found his true calling, straightened up, and got elected as governor of the college and finished his bachelor in theology in CPU College of Theology, and almost miraculously, with quite impressive marks too. He served for 3 years as the youth pastor of Ahoy Baptist Church and was recently installed as the new senior pastor of the same church. He is proudly and happily married to his loving and gorgeous wife, Christine. Christine is not just an excellent wife, but also a supportive partner in the ministry and the best mom to their equally wonderful daughter, Jackie. Our speaker is not just a pastor, but also a quote-unquote Spartan, participating actively and consistently in obstacle course races, specifically in the Spartan race, earning him a total of 5 medals from the prestigious race, which is held a few times a year in 25 countries all over the world. His daughter Jackie, at 5 years old, has also completed her first Spartan race in Cavite last February 2018, while his wife Christine is more inclined to do a trail running. As a family, they are all actively involved in outdoor and various sports activities and are passionate in pursuing active lifestyle while serving the Lord. Graduating pupils, parents, ladies and gentlemen, brethren in the Lord, please join me in welcoming our esteemed dedication service speaker, a proud product of our University Elementary School, Batch 1995, Pastor Christian Larry Cue.
Hi guys, first of all, I would like to congratulate all of you on your graduation and best wishes for your next adventure. Our scripture text is taken from 1 John chapter 4, verse 17 to 18, and it says, "Love has been perfected among us in this, that we may have boldness in the day of judgment, because as He is, so are we in this world. There is no fear in love, but perfect love casts out fear, because fear involves torment. But he who fears has not been made perfect in love." You know what, guys? Our texts are one of those texts that speak to an emotion. It doesn't speak about emotion, but it speaks to an emotion. Now, the question is, ano ni siya ang emotion ngayon eh? It's spelled as F-E-A-R. Fear, and we all have our own fears. You know what? I looked it up in the dictionary kung ano ang meaning sang fear. Kaga amuni ang hambal sang dictionary. Fear kuno is a distressing emotion aroused by impending danger, evil, pain, etc., whether the threat is real or imagined. Guys, na-notice ninyo ang duha ka words nga naga-describe sa word nga threat? Ano to ang duha ka words no nga naga-describe sa word nga threat? Real or imagined. You know, amo na ang aton nga mga fears, no, pwede nga real, kag pwede man nga imagination ta lang. No, imagination ta lang or real sa. You know, may isa ka anonymous nga writer nga naghimo sang acronym out from the word fear, kag sila niya ang fear kuno is false evidence appearing real. The sad truth is that many of us are living lives controlled by fear. And you know what, ining aton nga mga fear, it often arises in the form of condition that something bad might happen. You know, it's the what if and what might be. What if I fail? What if I say something and people will laugh at me? What if people won't like me? What if I get infected with the virus? What if my loved one, you know, what if my mama, my papa, my nanay, my tatay, my mommy, my daddy gets infected with the virus? What if my mama and my papa gets ill and lose their health? What if? Madugangan pagid sa mga what might be. You know, my mom and my dad, my nanay and my tatay, you know, my mama and my papa might lose their job. And what if they won't be able to pay for my tuition fees? How would I be able to finish my studies? You know what, guys? Most of the time, our conditional mights and ifs has no basis in reality. Most of the time, it finds its roots in something from our past. Most of the time, it finds its roots from the television shows na nalantaw natin sa una, no, sa mga nabasa natin sa social medias, sa mga nabatian natin sa radyo, no, sa mga nabasa natin ng mga books sa una. And you know what? Most of the time, it looms large in our imagination. Kagina magnify ini sa aton ng imagination. Kagina exaggerate ini kung kisa sa aton ng imagination. And eventually, it turns into fear. Guys, whether we fear the known or the unknown, the truth is that fear is a thief. It steals our joy, it steals our peace, it steals our happiness, and you know what? It robs us of sleep. Amo na bala kong gisa ko, hindi bala ko nadlukan ka, hindi ka katulog, ginapukaw ka sa imo kadlok, ginapukaw ka sa imo nga fear. No, kung gisa, ginot-ginot, nagitlang ka panghabol ka pa, kay nadlukan ka. No? And you know what? Kung maglalain niya ang aton na fear, it could prevent us from living God's promised abundant life. Di ba si Jesus, nagambal sila ni Jesus, I came that you might have life and have it to the full. And if you are living a life controlled by fear, you know, fear could prevent you from living God's promised abundant life. You know, a couple of days ago, I asked some of our young people to share to me their fears. And this is what they shared to me. No, hindi ko lang paghihambal ang mga ngalan nila. And by the way, word for word gini nga ginsulat na akon, no, ang gin-share nila sa akin, wala akong gin-edit. Siling isang isa ka young person, siling pas-ari nga akon nga fears damo-damo. Yung fear of failing, fear of disappointing other people and self, fear of commitment, fear of geckos to ko, fear of falling sa maling tao. Wow. Another young person shared to me, siya, my only fear, siya, pastor, siya, is not to make God happy in terms of my obligation as a Christian. Another young person shared to me, siya, fear of being rejected. Muna kung kisa, bisan gusto ko mag-speak out or gusto or suggest, may ara gid gapugong sa akon nga basi hindi man pwede. Another young person shared to me, siya, fear of losing my parents, fear of what others would think of me, fear of separation, fear of being worthless. Another YP said to me, sige nga, one of my greatest fears siguro pas is the deep dark waters. Do know nga nagsiman ko ah? Ha ha ha, kabaluman ko maglangoy pas, pero when it comes sa dalom, kag hindi ko makita ang sa dalom ko, nakulbaan ako pas, it feels like nga basi may magbutong sa akon padalom or what? Ha ha ha. Another young person shared to me siya fear of losing a loved one akon pas. No, another one shared to me siya, pastor, nahadlok gid ako nga madula ang akon pamilya sa kalibutan. Another young person shared to me siya, nahadlok ko madula ang mga precious people sa akon palibot, or to be more precise, nahadlok mabayaan. Now, going back, you know what, guys? Fears are inescapable because we have an enemy, and I think we all know his name. And you know what? This enemy of ours, he's only waiting for an opportunity to destroy us and to hurt us and to deceive us. And you know what? Most of the time, he attacks on those places of insecurity and magnifies them until they become fears. And sometimes, these fears are paralyzing. No, do hindi ka nakaubra. Do wala ka na sa may mahimo tungod sa imong fear. Guys, I want to remind you of this. I want you to remind. Gusto ko nga i-remind ka mo sini, that as children of the one true God, we must know that we are overcomers. Romans chapter 8 verse 37 tells us, know in all these things we are more than conquerors through Him who loved us. Guys, we are not just conquerors, but more than that, we are more than conquerors. You know, the challenge for us is this. Our goal as sons and daughters of the King of Kings should be that we believe this truth so deeply into our hearts that we not only combat our fears but fully and completely overcome them. But you know what? We have to do something. Ano nang dapat tayo mo? We have to humble ourselves before the Lord. We have to be humble enough and admit to the Lord, acknowledge before Him, recognize before Him, confess to Him, i-identify natin ang aton ng mga fears sa tubangan sa Ginoo. You know what? This time, I want you to consider the list of fears from our YPs na gin-share na akong kagina sa inyo, and also your own fears. I consider nyo itong mga fears kagina. sa mga young people naman sa church, kagang imo man nga fears. Now what did you notice? Notice that they are all future-based. Now if not all, many of them are, most of them are future-based. No, wala pa natabo, no, pwede gani. Pwede man nga matabo, there's a possibility nga matabo, pero may posibilidad nga kadako gid sang possibility nga hindi matabo. They are all maybes. No, it's more and you know what? It's more likely than not that they won't happen at all. But you know what? We still fear them. You know what? I like what Will Smith said in one of his sci-fi movies with his son, entitled After Earth. You know, sa movie nga ini, no, ang ilang kontra dire is an alien monster nga bulag na sa ang alien monster, but you know what, it can detect or sense fear sa iyang mga prey. And you know what, grabe gid ang kahadlok sa bata ni Will Smith sa sining alien monster, tungod nga nasaksihan niya gid naging kaon ng iyang older sister sa sining alien monster. And you know, one day while they were patrolling the space, ang ilang spaceship na crash and all the crew no sa ship na patay except for Will Smith kagang iyang bata. And you know what, Will Smith was badly injured and he asked his son to go and get some help. And you know what, do hindi magguha ang bata ni Will Smith sa spaceship kay grabe gid ang kadlok sa alien monster. No, balaan niya nga ma-detect gid sang alien, ma-sense gid sang alien monster ang iyang fear kag basi kaunon man siya. And you know what, this is what Will Smith said to him. Siling ni Will Smith saya, the only place that fear can exist is in our thoughts of the future. It is the product of our imagination causing us to fear things that do not at present and may not ever exist. This is near insanity. Now, do not misunderstand me. Danger is real, but fear is a choice. Yes, guys, the fear of the unknown is very real. God knew we would struggle with fear, so He equipped us with biblical truths to overcome that fear. He gave us His word to speak truths over our fears. You know, in 1 John chapter 4, verse 17 to 18, our text says, love has been perfected among us in this, that we may have boldness in the day of judgment, because as He is, so are we in this world. There is no fear in love, but perfect love casts out fear, because fear involves torment, but he who fears has not been made perfect in love. Guys, you know what? When we receive, experience and walk in the fullness of God's divine love, we need not fear anything. We also need to remember the truth in 1 John chapter 4, verse 17, which says, because as He is, as Jesus is, so we are in this world. Meaning to say that positionally, right now, even as I am talking to you, even as I am sharing this to you, you are as He is. Meaning, we have His blessings, we have His righteousness, His promises, His holiness. Guys, when we walk and live in the confidence in that kind of unconditional, extravagant, and generous love, we can trust God with each coming day. Fear cannot paralyze us. Fear will not be able to move us. And let me remind you of this. Romans chapter 8, verse 38 to 39 says that nothing in all creation, present or future, can come between us and God's love. Guys, we don't need to live a life imprisoned by fear and insecurity, because God's faithfulness ensures us that we'll live every day enveloped in His love and girded with His confidence. No, His love, God's love, especially as expressed through the promises in His word, speaks to every one of our conditional mights, every one of our what ifs. You know what? When our fears, when our fears arise, recognize them, capture them, and cast them deep into the ocean of God's love. Drown them with the truth until you hear them no more. I want you to remember this, guys. God is the answer, the only answer to all our fears. And you know what, guys? Each and every day, God is constantly inviting us to cast all, not just some, but all of our cares, all of our fears, all of our burdens, all of the things that are causing us to be afraid. He is inviting us to cast all of that upon Him. Guys, once again, congratulations and God bless.
My life is in your hands, and Okay, shall we pray? Loving God, you are the source of all blessings, good and perfect gifts. Today is a day of celebration, a day of victory. You taught us to encourage one another, to lift each other up. And today, we join together in rejoicing over the fruits of all the hard works, perseverance, and efforts of each of students, including their parents and teachers. As we celebrate the year and achievements of our children, we acknowledge that it's all because of your faithfulness, for extending their patience, for giving them the enthusiasm to learn, and for the joy of understanding. May they always remember that more than what is written in their report cards, character, values, and love are the lasting lessons to learn in life. Finally, we are grateful for the Christian training and growth that Central Philippine University continues to impart to our children. Be in our midst, O God, and receive all the glory, honor, and praise. In Jesus' name, amen.
Let us pray. O Lord our God, as we close this dedication service, we acknowledge that the dedication of our sons and daughters is not a one-time event, but a continual day-to-day dedication. We dedicate them to you, O God. May you continue to mold them and use them for your glory and honor. O Lord our God, we thank you for CPU, for educating our children not only on Scientia, but more importantly on Fides. May this faith in Jesus Christ grow and will lead to maturity. Lord, we claim the promise that you gave to Jeremiah. Let this promise be with our children. We believe that you have plans for each of them, plans to prosper them and not to harm them, plans to give them hope and a future. Let the prayer of Jabez be our benediction today. Bless these children, O God. Enlarge their territories. Let your hand be their guide. Keep them from harm so that they will be free from pain. May you watch over them, O God, in their coming and going, and until they meet again to face high school life. In Jesus' name, amen.